Hello, here you'll find a quick lesson on solution dilution. Solutions are often prepared at high concentrations to enable them to be stored in smaller volumes and be ready for use as needed. We call these concentrated solutions stock solutions. When working with the solute in solution, we often want it at a lower working concentration. And so in order to dilute the stock solution, we simply add more solvent until we achieve the concentration needed. It's important to note that when we dilute a stock solution, the amount of absolute solute in that vessel doesn't change. We're just increasing the volume. So the amount of moles of solute in the initial solution, or solution one, is the same as the amount of moles in the final solution, or solution two. Since concentration is a measure of moles of solute over volume, increasing the volume decreases the concentration. And so we can see that the concentration, whether it be in molarity or other units, is going to be inversely proportional to the volume. Inversely proportional means as one variable goes up, the other variable goes down. So if concentration is high, volume is low. If concentration is low, volume is high. In the image on the left, we can imagine a stock solution. And in this stock solution, we have a volume of approximately 200 milliliters. The magnifying glass gives us an idea of the amount of solute per that volume. And if you were to count out these dots, you would see that there are 10 dots per magnifying glass. That's a snapshot of the concentration of solute within this stock solution. On the right, we see the working solution, in which an additional 200 milliliters of water, or whatever the solvent be, have been added. Notice that the coloration is decreased. But when we look at the magnifying glass, we can actually quantify how much less solute there is per snapshot. Looking at the magnifying glass, we see 5 blue dots per window. So we've changed the volume twofold, going from 200 milliliters to 400 milliliters. And so the amount of solute per volume has decreased twofold, going from 10 particles per magnifying glass down to 5. We can use the equation M1V1 is equal to M2V2 in order to calculate the necessary volume or of stock solution needed to prepare a given amount of working solution. Typically, when we are diluting a stock solution, we are not taking the whole stock solution and diluting it to our needed working concentration. Rather, we take just enough that we need in order to perform our experiment. This way, the remaining stock solution can be used another day at a different concentration. And that stock solution is sitting on the shelf in a relatively small volume. In this example, we can see how a stock solution would be used to prepare a working solution. So on the left, we see our stock, and from it, we are measuring out a known volume of the stock solution using a volumetric pipette. That sample is moved over into a new volumetric flask where it is dispensed, and the remainder of the stock solution can be set aside. We then add the solvent into our small amount of stock solution, diluting it up to the mark on the volumetric flask, giving our working solution. So now that we have the concepts down, let's look at a practice problem. So here's a question. How would we prepare 3 liters of 0.5 molar calcium chloride from a 10 molar stock solution? Looking at this word problem, we want to apply our equation M1V1 is equal to M2V2. Applying these variables to our equation, we need to figure out what do we actually have here. We have a volume and we have two concentrations or molarities. are these concentrations initial or final? Well, reading the words, we could say we want to prepare 3 liters. So that's what we're making. So that's our final. So the 3 liters is our V2. And it's 3 liters of 0.5 molar. So that is actually our M2. The 10 molar is what we have as stock. So our stock concentration is known. What's missing is the variable V1. So just to tidy this up, we're going to isolate our V1 variable and say that it is equal to M2 V2 over, so dividing both sides by M1. So that means that the volume 1, so the volume of the stock, is going to be equal to 0.500 molar working solution times the volume of our working solution, 3 liters, divided by the concentration of our stock, which brings us to a volume of 0.150 liters or 150 milliliters, depending on how you like to write your measurements. If we then sub back in our determined value of 0.15 liters into our M1V1 is equal to M2V2 calculation, you can see how the amount of solute is conserved in our equation. If we take the stock of 10 moles per liter, and from that we only take 0.150 liters, that means we are extracting 1.50 moles out of the stock solution. Looking at our working concentration and volume, we wanted a solution of 0.5 moles per liter, and we needed 3 liters of that. Multiplying that out, again, you see the same 1.5 moles. So the solution could be readily prepared by measuring out the required volume, the 0.150 liters from the stock solution, adding that into a volumetric flask, and then diluting with water up to the mark of 3 liters, giving you the final concentration of 0.500 molar. So quick concept check, looking back at why we would have a stock solution. So imagine that initial stock solution from the previous problem, you had 1 liter of it. What would happen if you diluted the whole stock solution to get to that goal concentration of 0.5 molar? What volume would you end up with? Do you think that would be a reasonable thing to do?